Hello Internet and welcome to everWonder. Having spoken about low pressure areas in my Coriolis Effect video, I would like to talk about high pressure as well. Especially since high pressure areas rotate clockwise in the northern hemisphere and counterclockwise in the southern. Yes, this is not an error in the script. In the northern hemisphere, low pressure areas rotate counterclockwise, while high pressure areas rotate clockwise. And both do this because of the Coriolis Effect. But I'm getting ahead of myself. Let's start with why there are such areas in the first place. To even talk about pressure areas, we need to know why the wind is blowing. Imagine this box as our atmosphere. Just like our atmosphere, the pressure decreases with rising altitude because of gravity. So we've got a colder, low pressure area on top and a warmer, high pressure area on the surface. So far, nothing happens. But if we heat up one side of the box, more energy enters the air. It tries to expand and starts rising. This lowers the pressure on the surface while all the air molecules accumulate in this area, raising the local pressure. With this, we have created our first low pressure area on the surface. Since the pressure gradient wants to reach equilibrium horizontally, air molecules flow from high to low pressure areas. And now we have our wind, but with all the molecules piled up in the top part. So to equalize again and complete the cycle, the air is flowing back down, leaving us with our high and low pressure areas. So to recap, a low pressure area is created by rising air that draws in surrounding air, while a high pressure area is created by falling air that spreads out on the surface. Remember the video about the Coriolis effect. We stated that in the northern hemisphere, the wind is redirected to the right, while it flows to the left in the southern hemisphere. And you can already see that the low and high pressure areas are turning in opposite directions. Counterclockwise and clockwise in the north, while clockwise and counterclockwise in the south. And here are two bonus facts. High pressure areas are usually associated with dry weather, since cold air falls to the surface where it heats up. This lowers the humidity, resulting in dry weather. On the other hand, in low pressure areas, warm, humid air rises and thus cools down. Therefore, increasing the humidity may result in the formation of rain clouds if the air becomes oversaturated. For more on that, click the link in the info cards. And fact number two, if you place a high and low pressure area next to each other, you can already guess the direction of the wind due to their rotation, funneling the air from east or west depending on the position of the areas. And the faster the wind, the smaller the corridor between the areas. And with that being said, see you in the next video. Have a good one.